Extracting volume is essential for CFD simulations. Hello, I'm Armin. In this video, you'll learn how to extract the volume of an expansion chamber using SpaceClaim, Discovery, and Fluent Meshing. Let's get started. This is a simple expansion chamber, and I want to extract the internal volume for a CFD simulation. Let's take a look inside the chamber. I'll click on a surface and change the opacity from opaque to transparent. As you can see, there's a perforated baffle inside the chamber. In this section, I'll extract the internal volume using SpaceClaim. I'll navigate to the Prepare tab and select Volume Extract. There are two methods to extract the volume. The first method is by selecting caps. First, I choose the inlet and outlet caps. While holding the Control key, I pick another one. Next, I choose a seed face and click the green tick. As you can see, the volume has been successfully extracted. I'll press Escape and hide the solid part by unchecking it from the structure tree to get a clearer view. To see the extracted volume better, I can switch from transparent to opaque. Now, let's delete the extracted volume and try another method. Change opacity from transparent to opaque. I'll select Volume Extract again, but this time, I'll choose the Select Edges option. I select the interior edges while holding the Control key to pick multiple edges. Then I click the green tick. As you can see, the volume has been extracted successfully. Let's hide the solid part to get a clearer view of the fluid domain. What happens if the solid part has a small hole or gap? Let's test it out. I'll delete the extracted volume and add a small hole in the model. To extract the model, geometry must be closed. Before extracting, we must fill all gaps and holes. I'll try to extract the volume again using the same method. As expected, the volume isn't extracted because the geometry has a small hole on the exterior. Before extracting the volume, we must remove all redundant gaps. I'll do this by selecting the void, navigating to the Design tab, and clicking Fill to remove it. Let's follow the same process in ANSYS Discovery to extract the volume. In Discovery, I'll first switch the Explorer mode to Model to focus only on the geometry options. Then, I'll navigate to the Prepare tab, select Volume Extract, and follow the same steps as before. I'll select two caps by holding the Control key and also choose the inside face as a seed face. After that, I'll hit the green tick. As you can see, the geometry has been extracted. Now, I can hide the solid part to view the extracted volume more clearly. The second option for volume extraction is to use Fluent Meshing. We can also generate the fluid mesh within Fluent Meshing. I'll double-click on Fluent with Fluent Meshing and insert the geometry. Now, let's open the mesh. Specify 8 processors and check the double precision box. Then hit Start. Let's prepare the mesh. Navigate to Import Geometry and hit Import Geometry. This is the expansion chamber, and it only includes one solid part. I'll leave the default settings and hit Update. Now, let's move on to surface mesh generation. The geometry consists of only one domain, so we must divide it. I'll set the Separate Out Boundary Zone by Angle to Yes. These two surfaces are perpendicular, while the separation angle is 40 degrees. I'll hit generate. The surface mesh has now been generated. As you can see, the domain has been separated, and we can select the inlet cap. We can also select individual surfaces as needed. Currently, the geometry consists only of a solid region, but we need to extract the fluid domain. I'll select Geometry consists of only a solid region. Keep the option set to Yes, and hit Describe the geometry. Next, we need to select two caps, one for the inlet and one for the outlet. For the inlet, I'll select the inlet cap surfaces, ensuring that the zone option is enabled. By default, this is set as velocity inlet, so I'll hit create cap, and as you can see, the cap has been created. Now, I'll select the outlet, change its type from velocity inlet to pressure outlet, and hit create cap. Next, navigate to create regions. Since we have only one fluid domain, I'll hit create regions. As you can see, the surface mesh of the fluid domain has been created. In update regions, we have two domains, solid and fluid, which are selected automatically. We only need to hit update region. I'll leave the boundary layer options as default. Moving on to volume mesh generation, it's best to select Polyhex Core for better mesh quality. I'll hit Generate Volume Mesh and wait for the mesh generation to complete. The mesh has now been successfully generated. We now have two domains, the fluid domain, purple, and the solid domain, blue. In some simulations, the solid part is not required. To disable it, we need to go back to Update Region. Hit Revert and Edit, change Solid to Dead, and update it again. Dead means suppressed in this section. Update the boundary layer and generate the volume mesh again. As you can see, only the fluid region remains. Everything is set, and we can now proceed with the simulation. This tutorial ends here. If you found it helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Thank you for watching.